This is a special announcement. We've re-signed here at Kiss FM in a landmark deal that will see us both remain on air doing this show for 10 more years. Everyone. Not even your marriage you never even thought would go 10 years.
It's the longest deal in Australian radio history and the biggest. $200 million. That's $10 million each per year for a decade. With a cheeky $14 million in shares thrown in for good measure.
What sort of person
could take
would
all
rob
that money?
A company of that sort of money?
And if that's not sweet enough, Kyle and Jackie O have also scored an out-of-this-world clause where they can broadcast from anywhere on Earth.
See you later, loser.
The landmark deal will also see them enter the Melbourne brekkie radio market for the first time, which came as a shock to these guys, who found out late last night they're out of a job.
We don't want to say goodbye to Melbourne. We love this show. We love turning up every morning. We didn't have to be here this morning to make this announcement, but we're here.
Yep.
But will Melbourne tune in?
Get ready, censor.
Oh, God, don't.
Here we go.
Ready?
The duo is divisive, to say the least. Sanderlands found guilty of breaching the radio code on a number of occasions.
What a fat bit of thing you are. That's enough. You got a nothing job anyway. Just so you know, you're a piece of shit.
Been watching the Special Olympics?
Let's pick some of the things.
The monkeypox, the big gay disease floating around. It's only the gays getting it. Have you seen the dirty scabs that everyone gets?
Yet 800,000 Sydney-siders tune in each morning to the number one brekkie show.
More listeners than ever before.
So does the dynamic duo have what it takes to dominate for another decade?
You know what my manager said? I'd be eligible for a seniors card when this deal's up.
Steve Price has decades of radio experience. Pricey, $200 million. I mean, is anyone worth that?
Yes, I think Kyle and Jackie O are certainly worth $200 million. And the fourth guest on your panel tonight, Harry Connick Jr., will agree that if you are successful, people will pay you the big money. I mean, look, it's always about competition. If you work in FM radio like they do, there are a number of FM radio breakfast shows that like to have them because they win. And the fact that they're going to be kept away from their competition is because of the money.
Some of their Melbourne competitors, though, Steve, reckon they won't work in the Victorian market. Do you think they're right?
Well, Sarah, Kyle's a grubby buffoon, and I don't think grubby buffoons work in Melbourne. I probably shouldn't call him a grubby buffoon. He's just a grub.
That took a turn.
Jackie,
a really quick turn.
Melbourne will not embrace the style of that program as it is right now. Some of the sexually explicit material is off-putting. Sarah would know better than anyone else on that panel that it's school drop-off time for kids. You don't want people talking about anal sex at breakfast time, in my view.
Probably not during dinner time on national television either, Steve. But, you know...
Harry Connick, it's lovely for you to meet Steve Price.
I'm so glad to be here. This is wonderful. It's...
Well, I can't downplay the content of the show. That's what it's like. And Melbourne people are not going to embrace that. Look, the company that is putting them on the air obviously has a different view to that, and I may be proven to be completely wrong, but that doesn't happen very often.
So, Steve, you're not a fan, but there is no questioning they have massive appeal. What is it that keeps them so dominant on radio?
Well, lack of competition, perhaps, would be one reason. They've been there a long time. Longevity is huge in radio. I mean, the people who've been most successful on Sydney radio have been there a long time, and I talk about Ray Hadley, Alan Jones, Amanda and Jonesy. They're very successful as well.
They're not earning $200 million, though. They're not earning $200 million over a decade.
I spoke to them today, actually. I was on their show today. They sounded more expensive. slightly more expensive than the last time I spoke to them.
Can you put a price on that?
You have to put a price on it, which is crazy when you assign a number to that.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just a massive number. I congratulated them just because that's quite an accomplishment. Ooh, yeah. You know, 10 years. I've never heard of a 10-year contract in entertainment before. That sounds unprecedented.
Yeah. Speaking of the length of the contract, Pricey, Kyle is 52, and this deal, so I guess he's going to be in his 60s when this deal wraps up. Does a six-year-old, can they work? I know they're smutty already. Can a six-year-old still be smutty?
I don't think they can. I mean, and that is part of the problem. But Kyle seems to be ageless. I mean, I don't know how with that unhealthy lifestyle he has, but he doesn't seem necessarily to age all that much. And so perhaps he can at 62 still be, I won't refer to the sort of jokes he tells again because I got in trouble for it a while ago, but at 62, you can't imagine he's going to be appealing to the 18 to 28-year-old demographic that the radio station's paying for him to drag listeners in. I mean, I find that really puzzling.
Thanks, Pricey. Always good to talk.
Cheers.
So, Harry, we have put our hands together. We would like to offer you a 10-year contract on this show.
Yes.
TV money's a bit different. 200 bucks, we reckon.
I'm in.
Are you in?
Well, yeah. Where are we going to get 200 bucks from? Well,
pass that around. Yeah. I reckon these guys will be good for it.
It's big. I've been, like, angling for Pricey to adopt me because he's rich, but I think I need to go for Kyle now. This is big money.
It's interesting as well because I think after having his baby, Otis, he's sort of chilled out a bit, Kyle Sanderlands. You were on the phone with them this morning after the news had broken that, yes, they would be re-signing for this huge amount of money. How were they?
They were fine, you know.
They were real fine.
I mean, I heard about it right before I did the interview, and the first thing I said was congrats, just because, you know, we are in the entertainment business and to score that. I don't know their show. I think I've done it a few times over the years, so to see some of those quotes up there was the first time I've ever... I don't know what they do. I know Kyle from Australian Idol, and we had a good time. But you know, so that's just a heck of a lot of money. So congrats.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But you,